Hello, my name is Jacek Caballero. I'm studying law. I'm a CIDE student, and I want to know your opinion about Mexican immigration. Where are you from?
I am from Sacramento, California.
And what is your occupation?
I work as an education consultant for the California Department of Education.
What do you know about the construction of a wall to stop Mexican immigration into the United States?
Well, I know Congress in Washington, D.C. is definitely considering this, contemplated different measures to curb Mexican immigration on the southern border of the U.S.
Do you think that building a wall between Mexico and the United States violates human rights?
Do I think the wall itself would violate human rights? I would say yes, because right now it would be a very, if we built a wall, it would be a response to fear. And the way it would violate human rights is that right now, people who are crossing the border are crossing the border to survive, to improve their lives, to get a better job, to feed their families. So when they cross the border, number one, they risk their lives if they cross the border illegally. So they either pay someone money, they pay a coyote a certain amount of money, money they already can't afford, and a coyote will either deliver them to a certain point across the border. Often that exposes them to subhuman conditions. It could be a coyote could say, all right, I will take 20 people in a truck. Deliver them to San Diego, or deliver them to El Paso. But what would happen then is they would jeopardize their life if they're put in a truck without water, without food, without the basic human necessities, without, you know, sanitary conditions. So I would say it's a violation of human rights because it wouldn't take care of their basic needs. And if you build a wall, it's like putting your finger in a bucket that has a hole and it's leaking and it's not going to be the
should control illegal immigration than a binational program?
No, I think a national program would be better. A national program to provide official permission. Yeah. I think people would apply. I do. And I think that both countries would be better off. The United States, because I don't know how many, they would say numbers. And that would be accepting responsibility. And then it would also place the responsibility on the Mexican immigrants, who I think already share the burden of the responsibility because they risk their lives. So I think they would be, if they want to work, I think they would seek the permission to have a special card, let's say a green card, to work in the U.S. So I think that a program would be better because then you know the number of people. And the number can go up, it can go down. It depends on how many workers are necessary. And right now, the United States is fooling themselves. They're pretending, they're closing their eyes, and they're pretending that they don't need workers if they don't have a program. Well, go to the hotels, go to the restaurants, go to the fields, you will see who's working there.
Thank you very much for your opinion.
Oh, no.
That's all.